What is Bitcoin and what is DeFi? But you see, the real question should be, what is the Web 3.0? Only when you understand that will you be able to comprehend the potential and massive opportunity along with it. Imagine a new type of internet that not only accurately understands what you input, but actually understands everything you communicate, whether through text, voice, or other media. One where all content you consume is more tailored to you than ever before. You see, we are at the tipping point of a new phase in the web's evolution. Some early pioneers, they call it the Web 3.0. In this video, I want to explain to you briefly the history of the Web 1.0, Web 2.0, and then ultimately explain the benefits and the potential of the Web 3.0. But first, I want to welcome you to Crypto Never Sleeps. In case you're new to this channel and you want to stay on top of the crypto world, well then please hit like, smash, subscribe so that you can be notified every time we upload new videos. Furthermore, please come and join us for our live streams and cryptocurrency portfolio every Friday. My name is Nico Arachi and I'm the host of this little show. The Web 3.0 will be born out of a natural evolution of older generation web tools combined with cutting-edge technologies like AI and blockchain. As well, the interconnection between users and increasing internet usage. You see, apparently Internet 3.0 is an upgrade to its precursors, Web 1.0 and 2.0. Web 1.0, basically from 1989 to 2005, also called the static web, was the first and most reliable internet in the 90s, despite only offering access to limited information with little to no user interaction. Back in the day, creating user pages or even commenting on articles were not really a thing that happened. Web 1.0 didn't have algorithms to sift internet pages, which made it extremely hard for users to find relevant information. Simply put, it was like a one-way highway with a narrow footpath where content creation was done by select few and information came mostly from directories. The Web 2.0 was then launched in 2005 and is still the web that we are currently using. You see, we call it also the social web or Web 2.0. It made the internet a lot more interactive. And obviously that's thanks to the advancement in web technologies such as JavaScript, HTML5, CSS, and all the other programming languages, which enable startups to build interactive web platforms such as YouTube, Facebook, Wikipedia, Twitter, Telegram, and obviously also Amazon. This, however, paved the way for both social networks and user-generated content production to flourish, since data can now be distributed and shared between various platforms and applications. The set of tools in this internet era that we are currently living in was pioneered by a number of web innovators, like Mr. Jeffrey Seldman, who is often being regarded as the founder of the internet. Some of you might ask, where is the Web 3.0? Are we already using it? No, in fact, the Web 3.0 is yet to come. You see, it's the next stage of the web evolution that would make the internet more intelligent or process information with near human-like intelligence through the power of AI systems that could run smart programs to assist users. Now, Tim Berners-Lee had said that the semantic web is meant to automatically interface with systems, people, and home devices. As such, content creation and decision-making processes will involve both humans and machines. This will enable the intelligent creation and distribution of highly tailored content straight to every internet consumer. Arguably, there are a few early-stage Web 3.0 applications that are already existing today. But until the new internet becomes fully embedded in the web infrastructure, the true potential cannot be observed. That's also why I'm showing you here and talking about the huge opportunities such as Polkadot, such as Cardano, such as Ethereum. We are all waiting for the infrastructure of the Web 3.0 to be built. So what exactly is it and what is it going to look like? And how is it going to change our lives? But ultimately, when is it going to be live? The Web 3.0 was originally called the Semantic Web by worldwide web inventor Tim Berners-Lee. It was aimed at being a more autonomous, intelligent, and open internet. The Web 3.0 definition can be expanded as follows. Data will be interconnected in a decentralized way, which would be a huge leap forward to our current generation of the Internet Web 2.0, where our data is mostly stored in centralized repositories. Furthermore, users and machines will be able to interact with the data. But for this to happen, programs need to understand information both conceptually and context-wise. With this in mind, the two cornerstones of Web 3.0 are Semantic Web and Artificial Intelligence, AI. Now you're asking, what is the third cornerstone? Well, that is the Web 3.0 cryptocurrency and blockchain. As the Web 3.0 networks will operate through decentralized protocols, the founding blocks of blockchain and cryptocurrency technology, we can expect to see a strong convergence and symbiotic relationship between these three technologies. This will be interoperable, seamlessly integrated, automated through smart contracts, and used to power anything from microtransactions in Cardano's Africa, censorship-resistant P2P data file storage, and sharing with applications like Filecoin, to completely changing every company transaction, conduct, and operate their business. This current slew of DeFi protocols are just the tip of the iceberg. I hope this was not too complicated. I tried to make a complicated thing a little bit easier. Try to find some text that may shed some light to why we didn't understand it. I myself am not a programmer, nor do I understand very much from, you know, programming. But nevertheless, it seems to me that the Web 1.0 was the static. Web 2.0 was the social, where we were able to interact with each other. And the Web 3.0 is simply going to be a permissionless, uncensored, decentralized version of what we are seeing now. However, much more sophisticated. But that goes without saying that the future of finance is being built right in front of our eyes. It also goes without saying that until the Web 3.0, we won't really see huge, massive inflows of money, because only when the infrastructure of the Web 3.0 will be in place is when we're going to see mass adoption. My name is Nico Harachi. In case you enjoyed it, well then hit like, smash, subscribe, come join us for the live stream, and I wish you all the best, and I'll see you on the Web 3.0.